The Columbus Blue Jackets have avoided the Pittsburgh Penguins, but they'll get the Metropolitan Division champion Washington Capitals, perhaps entering this series a little bit more confident. Even though Washington had 105 points and played as well as anybody down the stretch, there is not a lot of chatter about the Capitals. Perhaps it is something to do with the endless playoff disappointments for the franchise. The Toronto Maple Leafs took a Capitals team that had the most points in the NHL last season to the brink in the first round. All six games were decided by one goal and five went to overtime. So why can't the Blue Jackets pull the first round upset? After all, it's hard to find a more motivated team in the playoffs, considering Columbus has never won a playoff series in franchise history. Washington won three of the four regular season meetings, three of which were played in the month of February. Maybe it's better for the Washington Capitals to have lower expectations. After all, this is a team that has eight division titles since the 2007-08 season and hasn't even been to the Eastern Conference Finals. The Capitals have lost in the second round each of the last three seasons. Running into Pittsburgh certainly doesn't help, but getting over the hump just hasn't been in the cards. Offensively, Washington hasn't been as dominant this season, as they narrowly finished in the top 10 in goal scoring. Alex Ovechkin was double and triple shifted against New Jersey in hopes of getting him another 50-goal season, but he had to settle for 49. Nobody else had more than 27. The Capitals did get a lot of scoring up and down the lineup, with 11 guys in double digits. John Carlson finally stayed healthy for all 82 and had a breakout year with 68 points. Matt Niskanen missed some time, but he is about as healthy as he has been during the regular season. Defensive depth is still a problem for Washington entering this series. Injuries played a role, but finding guys behind Carlson, Niskanen, and Dmitry Orlov to eat up minutes has been a real problem. Brooks Orpik is still limited offensively and is slow out of the pivot. Kristen DeJuice, Madison Bowie, Taylor Chorney, Jacob Jerebek, and Michael Kempney all took turns trying to plug holes for the Capitals. The defensive play leaked over to the goal crease. Brandon Holtby was bad this season, posting a 2.99 goals against average with a .907 save percentage. The 28-year-old hadn't had a GAA over 2.22 since the 2013-14 season, and this is far and away the lowest save percentage of his career, so it may be possible that Philip Grubauer gets the Game 1 start. Over his last 26 games played, Grubauer posted a .940 save percentage. We will have to see how long Holtby's leash is, as we know Barry Trotz wants to rely on his horse from the last three seasons. But Grubauer simply may not be the better option right now. For all of the questions the Columbus Blue Jackets have entering this series, goaltender is not one of them. Sergei Bobrovsky is the guy for John Tortorella. The man known simply as Bob posted a 2.42 goals against average and a .921 save percentage in his 3,900 plus minutes this season. But Bobrovsky was terrible in the series against Pittsburgh last season and was also bad in the series against Pittsburgh back in 2014. He has some playoff demons to overcome, and he better overcome them quickly, because the Blue Jackets spent most of the season scuffling offensively. They did get on track late in the year as Cam Atkinson got healthy and Artemi Panarin simply took over, but this is a team whose second leading scorer is defenseman Seth Jones. When all the dust settled, the Blue Jackets finished 7th in 5-on-5 goals. That really saved their season because the power play was terrible most of the year and wound up 25th for the season. Anaheim is the only other playoff team to finish below 20% on the power play. What often separates Washington from first-round opponents is depth. The Capitals have tremendous depth up front, but they're a bit weaker on defense this time around. The Jackets are the same way, having good forward depth and can roll four lines, but Seth Jones and Zach Werenski were the only defensemen over 20 minutes of ice time. They'll play a ton in this series and are likely to be tasked with stopping Alex Ovechkin. That is a big worry for Columbus because Jones was second in points and Werenski was sixth. Having to defend against Ovechkin takes away some of the offensive freedom for those two guys, and the Blue Jackets don't generate a ton of offense otherwise. This should be a low-scoring series if both goaltenders can hold up their ends of the bargain. That, however, is not a certainty with Holtby's play this season and Bobrovsky's playoff efforts. Columbus stacks up better with Washington than they would have with Pittsburgh for the second straight season, but Washington's offensive depth should eventually win out in this series. Washington's lack of defensive depth should not show up here, since Columbus doesn't have a ton of offense on the bottom lines and doesn't have a potent power play. It will be a factor down the line, but the Washington Capitals should advance from this series. This line opened with Washington at minus 125, so they are the preferred side out of the gate on early betting action. Subscribe now so you won't miss any of our NHL videos and also get updated betting odds with all our expert picks and predictions. Click over now to betdsi.eu to check out all the NHL betting odds on the board, along with a slew of fun and exciting novelty prop bets on your favorite players and tournaments. Take advantage of getting more than 3 times your money if you open an account today with a 100% deposit bonus and a $25 free bet. Join the action with a few fun wagers because it's only a game until you bet it.